Hello, and today we are with Mr. Arseniy Tagaev, who is the general manager of the Novotel Living and Ibis Almaty Jetisu in Kazakhstan. Good afternoon to you, Arseniy.
Good afternoon, Stephen.
Now, I'm very excited about this property because, first of all, it's one of the newest hotels in Almaty, but it's also the first dual-branded hotel, which is becoming a bit of a popularity in the industry. What does it mean exactly that this is a dual-branded hotel with two different Accor brands within it? What does that mean?
Right. This is the latest, not the latest, it's been a trend for a while for Accor to work on a combo. That's what we call combo hotel. And in fact, the two brands under one roof, it really brings you an advantage as an operator, as well as a great advantage for investor. And there are a few reasons for that. And the main one is that we cover the different demand in the city. Being located centrally, guests can choose between the Accor brand and the mid-scale brand, which is a good option to attract various groups of people having different travel reasons. And at the same time, it is a quite reasonable investment in terms of the hotel, because you have the main infrastructure is the same for both hotels. So with one engineering and IT infrastructure, you can bring more expanded product to the market, which is a great advantage for investor.
Now, of course, a lot of travelers will know the Novotel brand, they'll know the Ibis brand, but they might have also noticed the fact that this is called a Novotel Living Almaty Jetisu. What does exactly that mean? What is a Novotel Living property?
That's a very new brand for Accor. And based on the fact that you just mentioned that Novotel is a core brand, it really made sense for Accor to create something new using the well-known name, which I think is very beneficial in terms of the market recognition on the market. Novotel Living is a new brand which allows our guests to book the room with a long-staying purpose, which still brings you the value of Novotel, but at the same time, all our rooms, for example, including the studios, are equipped with a full kitchenette. Therefore, guests are able to come here with the family, to cook the food themselves, to store the items in the fridge. So it really brings you a benefit of an apartment, at the same time knowing the Novotel service. This brand is being developed only from this year, from last year, sorry. And we were the first hotel in the whole region that opened under this brand. And there are still a few standards which are being finalized. We were kind of running ahead of the train with the opening, but I'm really proud to have this new product on the market, which I'm sure will become more and more known among the international travelers.
Do you share all of the facilities? And the reason I ask this is because I've been very impressed with the breakfast while I've been here, and it's more Novotel than Ibis, which of course, if you're paying the Ibis rates, makes the exceptionally good value for breakfast. In terms of the actual facilities at the hotel, how does that work and what benefits are there with this dual branded when you actually have the two different brands, one higher than the other?
Well, the value, I think, for the customer is that, again, he can choose. At the same time, for me, as for operator, it's really a cost-saving issue because I have one reception, I have one housekeeping team, etc., etc., and all the people within the team, they are multifunctional, they work for both brands. So in terms of effectiveness, for me, that's really an advantage. And for the guests, for example, Ibis guests, which are staying within our property, they have a great opportunity to use the fitness center, which is not normally the case for Ibis. And that actually brings an additional value for our customers. And as you just mentioned, the breakfast, we're trying to following the Novotel standards, basically, so the guests which are paying less will still get the benefit of a good selection for breakfast. So I think this combination is really a great value and great push for the market.
Now, technology is changing all the time, constantly, and very fast when it comes to hotels. How are these two properties, well, it's one property, how are the two brands within this one property embracing new technology to make your life easier as a hotelier, but also those for the guests that are staying here?
Well, in terms of technology, I think Ibis, being as eco brand, is following the regular market initiatives in terms of technology. So we have the internet, we have the locks, electronic locks, etc., etc., all the standard things. But for Novotel, as a mid-scale or even upper mid-scale class, for in our case, it is differently equipped. It's a different market. As I mentioned, we have a really modern kitchenette with all the latest up-to-date equipment. All the rooms in Novotel Living are equipped with that's what we call the smart home. So the curtains, for example, they can be opened and closed with either a button, or we even have a voice assistant, which is called Alice. Alice doesn't speak any other languages except Russian, unfortunately, but it's still a great value. And the Alice, this voice assistant, is known on the market in Kazakhstan. So when we have our local customers visiting, our local guests, they're really happy and they're enjoying the Alice service, because she can switch on your TV, turn off the lights, etc., etc. So I think that's a great benefit for the people that are paying more or less the same rate in my hotel as in the sister properties in the city. But I have this advantage of being super high technology. So that's one of the key selling points for Novotel Living.
Now, of course, Air Astana are expanding their network as they get more and more airplanes into their fleet. Air Indigo is about to launch flights from Delhi to Almaty. Qatar Airways recently resumed flights. More and more airlines are launching flights to Almaty, to Kazakhstan. For those that don't know the city, what advantages are there in terms of the location of this property? Why is this location suitable for business and leisure travelers?
Well, let me start from the beginning. The actual project which we realized here, it's built on the site of an old hotel, and actually we are located in the very what we call golden square of the city. Basically, that's an old part of the city. All the new buildings, they're a bit higher, closer to the mountains, but we're located in the historical, really central part of the city. And at the same time, we're not far away from the airport. So our location is an advantage both for business travelers, so not to travel and get stuck in the traffic jams traveling all the way up. So we're kind of in between the business area and the airport. So it's a nice area for layover passengers who come for one or two nights. And at the same time, it's really a tourist area. We have a old Arbat Street here with all the artists which display the arts on the street. There is a green market, and it's one of the oldest markets in Almaty, where the international tourists can go and buy some local things. So I think it's really a great location, so we benefit both for business travelers as well as for leisure tourists.
Now, of course, you have a strong domestic market here in terms of guests, but outside of the domestic market, which are your top five markets, and where are you trying to concentrate your sales efforts over the next 12, 24 months?
Well, I think our second biggest market is, it's definitely Russia, because we are not far away, and considering some of the events that happened in the nearest past, the Russia is a big supplier for our market. But at the same time, we are really, Almaty has been expanding a lot in terms of international presence on the Middle East market. Therefore, our number two supplier for the international tourists is United Arab Emirates. And a few other countries within the Gulf region are also increasing the volume. So, and this is mainly in summer. At the same time, as you mentioned, we had a few flights launched with some of the Asian countries. So India is coming soon. We had a Pakistan flight from Pakistan, which is also supplying the market. And we're expecting in the end of the year to launch the flight, if I'm not mistaken, by Air Astana with a local low coster from Malaysia. So that will bring us additional volume from Malaysia as well.
Oh, very interesting. So in terms of the Thai market as well, Singapore, these types of markets, are these growing markets? Are they increasing in the terms of number of arrivals that you get from those countries?
I think the volume is still not that high that we would like it to be. Definitely China is growing, especially after they opened the borders with this post-COVID period. Vietnamese guests, we have quite a few guests from Vietnam because of this also charter flights, but not that many. So we are mainly working on the Middle East market, with the Middle East market, but we are hoping to get the Southeast Asian market growing here as well, especially with the new flights which are being launched within the next few months.
Now, a lot of hotels are talking about sustainable initiatives. I know that you do have a few here, some of your favorites. What are some of these sustainable initiatives that you have here at the hotel?
Well, like most of the other hotels, we collect the plastic and the carton and the papers, and we refine them. We have a contract with a company that takes all the plastic and the paper, and they refine it. At the same time, in 2023 made a promise to our guests that we'll get rid of all the guest-facing single-use items, and they are all plastic-free. So I think this is one of the key initiatives that Accor promised, and we are fulfilling this. For example, we've got rid of all the plastic bottles in the rooms in terms of drinking water, and we've installed the purifiers in the guest corridors. And I think it's really beneficial both for hotel in terms of the environmental initiative, and at the same time for the guests, because now the guests can use as much water as they want. And they don't have to ask the housekeeping, and the nearest, the furthest location of our purifier is only 30 steps from the room. That's as far as you have to go. So I think it's a good benefit both for environment and for the guest service, for the guest comfort.
A lot of hotels are talking about recruitment challenges that they're facing. And of course, you're receiving now many more guests from non-traditional markets, which brings with it language issues and cultural understandings that are required from the staff. What challenges are you faced in terms of recruitment, and how are you overcoming those challenges?
Well, the recruitment has never been easy here. And as you correctly mentioned, we are focusing on the local market to get the local people working with us and developing the industry. At the same time, I have a few people in the team which speak the languages of the countries where we have the most guests from. For example, I have a couple of Turkish-speaking people. I have an Arabic-speaking person at the front office. And a couple of other languages. We're not like super international team in terms of the languages as you might meet in Dubai or some other major international destinations. But at the same time, we're trying to recap the most used languages within our team. Yes, it's not easy, but we're getting there slowly.
Now, I know you have a lot of experience in the industry, and you've been part of the pre-opening team on many different properties. What is it about being part of a pre-opening team, managing the pre-opening of a property, that you enjoy?
Yeah, well, I think once you get into it, you really feel that it becomes the passion of your work. Before I opened my first hotel, I spent 8 years in two properties which were running and operating for a few years. But after my first opening of the Marriott Hotel in Astana, I really had a feeling that this is mine. This is something that I want to do. And since then, and by now, I've opened the four hotels. I've done four openings. And this is really something that I want to continue doing, because it becomes your passion. This is ticking the box and moving further. And I'm not the person who would stay for years at the same place. It is important to launch the hotel, but not only to open it, but to make it run for at least a year or a year and a half after the opening. And once you've done that and the hotel is running the full speed, this is where you say to yourself, I've done it. It's time to do something new. So yeah, that's a great experience, and I think I would love to continue opening the hotels in various destinations, either it's Central Asia or somewhere else.
Well, I was going to ask you there, because of course you've worked in Russia, you've worked in Astana, you've worked in many different places. Where, if the world was your oyster, what part of the oyster would you like to work in if you had a choice?
To be honest, it's been my dream, not a dream, but a real desire to try myself in Southeast Asia. Same with my wife and my family. My wife she's also a hotelier, and that destination for Southeast Asia, Thailand, maybe Vietnam in particular, this is the places where we'd like to try ourselves. So if the destiny will bring us there one day, we'll be more than happy. But at the same time, I know the Central Asia market quite well, and I know the local the community, I know the local habits, etc. So I feel very comfortable here. So let's see where we'll end up for the next project. But whatever the fate brings us, we'll be happy to take it and continue moving forward.
Excellent. Well, Arseniy, I have to say thank you very much indeed for your time today. And of course, I wish you and everybody at the Novotel Living and Ibis Almaty Jetisu here in Almaty, of course, Kazakhstan, the very best of luck. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Stephen.